With changes to abortion laws south of the border, we get reaction from both sides of the debate here in Canada.
You know, there is a need to accept equal rights for all human life.
It's going to be a big fight, and we need to be ahead of the game.
Both Alberta Pro-Life and Alberta Pro-Choice see states like Alabama's political moves to ban abortion as a call to action for them to take on political lobbying. In Canada, access to abortion was granted 31 years ago under a Supreme Court decision that criminalizing the procedure went against the Charter of Rights and Freedom. But for Karen Richard,
two human lives that we're dealing with, especially in the, you know, in the case of abortion, and we need to find a way to balance those rights.
She's optimistic there's a shift in the political landscape, even as provincial leaders who previously opposed abortion have been clear they do not plan to enact legislation on the topic.
Human life is sacred.
Still, their goal is to elect more politicians with similar viewpoints.
I'm being realistic, and I think that we're probably going to have to look at small bites in Canada, because I don't think the electorate is ready to move in that direction all at once.
A 2017 Ipsos poll said 77% of Canadians agree with abortion being legal. But still, this doesn't mean work stops for abortion rights advocates.
I would say that the anti-choice down in the States are about 10 years ahead of us, in that they've been able to control the message in the schools. They've been able to control the message in the public realm.
Kathy Dawson says they will be watching to see if public funding goes to any groups against the procedure and what is said in schools.
I think that everybody has a right to decide when I'm going to parent, if I'm going to parent, how many children I'll have, how many I won't have.
As both sides in Canada watch closely what is happening south of the border. In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.